Now, let us discuss about objectives of production management. In that, the first one is to produce the goods as per the quantity demand by the customer. Now, the main objective is what? Okay. Now, in the organization, now whichever the goods have been produced or which goods have been manufactured, the customer should be satisfied. Okay. If those goods have been sold in the market. The main objective is what? Customer satisfaction. Now imagine that there is one company, that is ABC Limited, one company is there, and this company has manufactured any kind of the products, means some new or innovative product they have manufactured, and they have sold that product in the market. Okay. Now after selling that product in the market, now if the customers will not purchase that product only, okay, that time what happens? The company will come into loss, because the customers have not at all purchased that particular product. So the main objective is what? There should be customer satisfaction. Okay, means the customer should be satisfied after purchasing that product from the market. So before that, no, the company should try to understand whatever are the taste and preferences of the customer. Now different customers' opinions or different customers' taste or preferences will be different. So they need to target the customer, okay, and try to study the market or try to understand, okay, the taste and preference of the customer, and after that sell that products in the market. So to produce the goods as per the quantity demand by the customer, okay. Now understand the customer satisfaction, and then they need to sell those particular products in the market. And quantity demand by the customer. Quantity demand by the customer means what? Now imagine that customer will demand something 50 quantity of products. So customer will demand something 100 quantity of products. Means those many quantity of products should be sold to the customer. Then the next objective is to maintain as well as to increase the level of customer satisfaction. To increase the level of customer satisfaction means what? Now the company can earn profit, or the company's sales will be increased only when the customers have been satisfied. Now you cannot tell that the company which is there, it is selling so many products, okay, then why the company is not gaining more sales, or why the company is not gaining more profit, okay, why it is not gaining? So because the customers are not satisfied. So they have to keep in mind that whenever any products have been sold in the market, the customer satisfaction should be there, or there should be a customer satisfaction. So that is the second objective, to maintain as well as to increase the level of customer satisfaction, means how they can increase the level of customer satisfaction. Then the next point is to make improvement in existing goods and services by regular innovation. Now how they can make improvement in the existing goods and services? Now when we speak about the term innovation, innovation is not only introducing some new products which are there, that is completely new product, but also they can do one thing, that existing goods and services which are there. Existing means what? Means at present whichever the products have been available, for that only they can try to make improvement, or for those existing products only some new innovative things can be added, or maybe some new packaging can be done, new labeling can be done, new brand name can be given for that particular product, or some other new features can be added in that particular product. So to make improvement in the existing goods by regular innovation. So innovation means it need not be only completely new product which is there, but also the existing products which are found in the market, means at present whichever the products have been there, for that only completely means some kind of a changes or improvement can be done in that particular product. Like simple example is there. See, old products which were there, means the products which were used in the olden days, that only in this trend which is there in modern technology, how they can try to change the traditional old techniques which were there, in convert that into the modern trends, or convert that into the modern technology. by introducing something new techniques or introducing something new technology or new innovative things in that. Then the fourth point is to maintain inventory at such levels and there may not be blockage of working capital. So they can try to maintain the inventory also in such levels which are there. Then you can see the next point, to ensure supply of goods and services in right quantity at right time at right place. Now whenever there is a supply of goods and services, supplying means what? Okay, like imagine that there are two companies. The one company is ABC Limited and other one is XYZ Limited. So one company, it is supplying the goods to the other company. So whenever the supply of goods and services have been done, it should be there in right quantity at right time and right place. Now what do you understand by these three terms? Right quantity, right time and right place. Now imagine that one company has ordered some quantity of goods. Now they have ordered something 50 quantity of goods. This is a quantity. Quantity means the number. Number means how much quantity of goods they have been ordered. So if they have ordered 50 quantity of goods, so it is required that the company will supply 50 quantity of goods, means right quantity. Okay. Now there should not be surplus or shortage. Like suppose if 50 quantity of goods have been ordered, if they supply some more or extra quantity of products to the other company, so that will be a wastage. Or they should not try to supply the less quantity also. Means if they have ordered something 50 quantity, it doesn't mean that they will, I mean, suppose for example, if they supply something 40 products or 30 products, means less than the quantity ordered, that time what happens, they will fall a shortage. Means this much, means suppose if 40 quantity they will send and 50 quantity has been ordered, that time what happens, there will be shortage of 10 products, means 10 products will fall shortage. Okay, that is right quantity. Quantity means in right number the product should be supplied, and right time and right place also. Right time means what? See, whenever the goods have been ordered, no, they will specify that particular date. Okay, on that particular date the goods should be properly supplied. That is called as a right time. Means there should not be any delay. Okay, there should not be any delay in the supply of products. Now suppose they will specify that, okay, the company which has been ordering, no, they will tell that on this particular date only the goods are to be sent. Okay, now when the goods they have ordered or mentioned on this particular date, the other company should try to supply on that particular time or that particular date. They should not make any delay in the supply of products. And at right place also. So these three terms you need to remember in that. That is right quantity, right time and right place. Okay, the quantity also should be, means exactly how much number is being ordered by the other company. The company should try to supply that much quantity and it should be there at the right time and right place. Okay, so these three things, these three terms you need to remember in this point. So in supply of goods and services. Then the next objective is to produce the goods as per the market demand. Now, already I have told you that, okay, the company which has been producing the goods or manufacturing any kind of a products, that should be there as per the market demand or as per demanded by the market. Because what happens, the customer's taste and preferences will be different. Now if I am having one company, I will sell one product in the market. And if the customers will not purchase my product, okay, then what happens? My company will go into loss. So first try to understand the market demand, means what is the demand for that particular product, whether customers demand that particular product or no. Okay, then afterwards only the company should decide or the company should make proper arrangement of selling those products in the market. But that should be there according to the market demand. Means demand by the customers, means what is the demand for that particular product in the market. Then the next point is to keep proper maintenance of plant and machinery. Means here proper repairs and maintenance has to be done. Like usually what happens now during the production process, we will take one example of that process, okay? That is process 1, process 2 and process 3. What happened in the process 2? Okay, now the workers are working in that particular processes, okay? That time the machinery which they were using, it was a little defective part of the machinery was there. There was no proper repairs and maintenance. So when the worker started working on that machinery, he got hurt while working in that machinery. So now the company should take proper care of proper maintenance. They should try to maintain the machinery, proper repairs and maintenance has to be done of the machinery. Because if the machines are not being repaired properly or no proper maintenance is being done, that time what happens? The workers will get hurt while working on that particular machine. So these are the objectives of production management. Now briefly you only understand that now whenever the companies are producing any kind of the product, it should be as per the demand of the customer. And also there should be what customer satisfaction means. If the company is selling the goods to the customer should be satisfied. And they need to make improvement in the existing goods and services. Means it need not be the complete new product which is there, but existing goods only. For that existing products only they can make some innovative thing. And also they should try to supply the goods and services in right quantity at right time and right place. Means the quantity also should be correct number and right time also in that at that particular time only and right place. And to produce the goods as per the market demand, means as per the demand of the customers or market, the goods are to be produced. And they should try to maintain the machinery, means proper repairs and maintenance of plant and machinery has to be done.